This year, I'm only conducting one plot of urine test, in this area which I spent last summer mowing to the level of our lawn. A review of just watching the plots used in previous years can be found in a separate video released last week. In this mowed grass area, I'm setting up four plots. In each of these plots, other than the control to the extreme right, I will apply an equal amount of liquid during each application. From left to right, it'll be 100% urine, half water, entirely water, and then a control with nothing applied. As a follow-on to last year's water-only test, this will provide a constant liquid application but added urine to the application mix. It's May 23rd today, only a week and like 6 hours after the first application of urine that I put on these plots. And I can already see a pretty substantial difference. These two plots, this one here and this one here, have had urine applied to them. This one in 100% concentration and this one in 50% concentration. While this one here has had 100% of water applied to it, and this has had nothing other than natural rainfall, which all of these have gotten. And these plots that have had some urine applied to them are really quite darker green than the other plots. And I noticed this yesterday after only two times I've applied urine, and though I've applied it these last 2 days, it's really quite substantial how much I've noticed that this plot is like this super dark green, while the other one is just the same kind of regular lighter green grass color. I haven't noticed any real difference in the growth of the grass. Likely it hasn't really happened yet. The species representation across these plots are quite similar, whether they're the urine fertilized plots or the other plots, kind of as a baseline. They have a mix of various grasses, a little bit of tangleweed, and a little shrubby thing. I don't know what it is, a little leafy thing, and some sedges here or there. A week later, May 29th, I can now see a pretty significant height difference between the fertilized grass and the unfertilized grass. The fertilized grass has a height of 4 to 5 inches, up to 6 inches in some areas. The unfertilized grass has a height of 2.5 to 3 inches, kind of on average. And the grass I just mowed, where this would have started at last week, Sunday, this has not been mowed since last week, Sunday, 6 days ago, is at about 2 inches. So you can see that that grass is growing, but this fertilized grass is growing much, much quicker than the unfertilized stuff. It's pretty significant amount of water or urine or mix that I've been applying. In the 2 weeks since I started doing applications on here, I've put down just under a quarter inch of water urine mix in each of these plots across the whole area. We've received just over a quarter inch of rain, and so the amount of water I put in here, like in this plot, has received 93% of the rain, or 193% of the total water that, like the control plot, which has received nothing, has. And these have the same amount since then. Now 2 weeks later, June 13th, and there's quite a significant change in this plot that I was applying just urine to. It's quite brown, with a lot of dead grass in it. There is some live grass around the edges and one strip down the middle, which might be from where the lawnmower wheels were, and a few sprigs through the brown area, but it's almost completely brown. The one really notable thing is that the dandelions in there are coming up. So I've clearly over-fertilized this. And to some degree, I was hoping that would happen, but I wasn't expecting it this soon, especially because I don't think I've been putting a ton of urine on these compared to what I've put on plots previously. But admittedly, it's been drier now since basically any other time I've been doing this experiment. In the past week, we've gotten virtually no rain. And the week before that, there was some rain, but not all that much. And in general, we are just feeling very dry this time of year. It's really dry, and even drier than we get sometimes at all summer. The other plot, this half and half one, there is a little bit of die off, but that could just be due to the drought. There are other patches around the lawn which are starting to go brown just due to lack of water. And the other two plots seem to have no effect on them at this point. So I'm not putting any more urine fertilization on this. The last time I put any on was a week ago. It's July 11th, and it can be seen that the grass in the fertilized plots, either the full fertilization or the half and half with water that I'd done previously, it's continuing to grow. And since the last time I was filming, I have not added any water or urine to this area. But I am seeing some amount of die-off in this the plot that has half and half, which I wasn't seeing earlier. So even that might be too intense. And the tall grass isn't in every location in those plots, just some of the locations. Along some of the edges along here, there it looks about more normal. And this has been a week since it's been growing. But it's not just those plots that I'm doing. I set out some other plots. There's still the 16 square feet. There's three of them along this back edge, but they aren't the square, and the control is the same. And the reason I'm doing this is because I want to do something more. And one of the questions I've had in previous years is kind of, what if I fertilized partway through the season? What if I did that start partway through the season instead of just at the beginning of the season? Because as the summer progresses, the growth of grass slows down. Admittedly, right now the grass seems to be growing back as fast as like when I started this, or close to it, because we just recently had a wetter spell after some pretty dry period, though it's still dry. So I am going to fertilize some more plots, but it may not be fully representative. I continued applying urine to that plot over the course of a month. Again, I saw a very quick response for the color of the grass turning darker green, followed by an increase of growth rate. I ended the application once I saw a small amount of the grass in this new plot dying off. I continued to see a small amount of the die-off in this newer plot, but it never took over the plot like the earlier one. It also only affected the 100% urine plot this second run. The second run also recovered quicker, with grass growing well in the entire area by the end of the growing season, while the first one still had a large dead patch. When comparing the two sets of fertilization, while the total amount of liquid applied was similar, 0.52 inches for the first run and 0.45 inches for the second run, there were substantial differences that does not represent. The second run was done over a longer time period of 37 days as opposed to the first one's 22 days, resulting in an application rate of 0.71 inches per month for the first one and 0.36 inches per month for the second, nearly half the rate. In the days that it was being applied, only 1.22 inches of rain fell for the first plot, while 6.59 inches of rain fell for the second plot. This resulted in the applied liquid adding 43% to the volume of the first run, while only 7% of the second run. It seems likely that this lower rate of application and the much higher dilution of natural rainfall during the second plot resulted in the differences. For both plots, evidence of the beneficial effect of urine fertilization disappeared fairly fast, with only the second 100% urine plot showing the benefit at the end of the growing season. This is different than what I believe I have seen in previous years' plots, which show a difference even years after receiving the fertilization. This year is short grass, which I've been told has shorter roots.
Though this was also recently long grass, but even that original long grass is quite a bit shorter than the reed canary and other species which were seen in the previous year's plots. It seems clear that in my climate, water does not improve the growth of grass, or at least the fairly small amount of water applied, which did not even come to bring the water received by the grass to an average year. The only spot I noticed a difference in species was in the areas of the first 50-50 plot that died off, which first grew back as bedstraw. That, and the dandelion seeming being able to handle the fertilization more than the other species in that 100% plot. Thank you.